So before I start the topic, I am going to take you, basically I'm going to draw your attention to many pictures here. Now one by one we are going to discuss these pictures. In the first picture,
this 11th grade portion, why are they going to teach this?
Yeah, please, can you mute yourself? Thank you so much. So in the picture, the person is kicking the football. I want to know what is the force which is acting on the football after being kicked. Can you tell me? Not during the kick, but after the kick. Okay. Now, this is again extreme sport. Here also, once the motorcyclist, he leaves the ramp, what is the force acting? No idea?
Is it gravity?
Gravitation.
Yes. Very good. Who was that?
Amara.
Amara. Yes, Amara. I can feel you're a very interactive child. Yes. So next we are moving to another picture. As Amara has already told, what is common in all these pictures? Because once you leave the arrow, what happens? It is again under the influence of... Very good. The same happens with the water fountain. Yes. So now, when I say what is common in all the pictures, it is that once the object leaves its cause of motion, it is under the effect of only one force, and that is gravitational force. Yes, Amara, can you tell me the direction of gravitational force?
Towards the earth, center of
towards
the earth.
Very good. Yes. So basically what we are going to learn today, that is projectile motion. And you have already deduced what is projectile motion. A motion in which an object is projected with some initial velocity and it is under the influence of only one force, and that is your gravitational force. Okay, so now before I start the analysis of projectile motion, we need to have certain assumptions. As you already know, assumptions are very important in physics. Yes. So what all we are going to assume, the first, the value of acceleration due to gravity, small g, it is constant. The second thing, the rotation of Earth, we are going to ignore right now during our analysis, as well as the air resistance. Yes. Now, keeping these assumptions in mind, I am going to show you certain projectiles. Okay. Now, see here. I'm going to send you the link of this simulation so you can try it yourself. Okay, you can play it like a game also, where you need to just hit the target. I missed it. Can I do something else? Wow. Yes, this is a kind of horizontal projectile wherein the angle is zero. What about if I change the angle? So many things change. The path. Can you tell me what all is changing? I see the path changing. Then?
Direction
changes. What about the distance in the horizontal direction?
It's increasing.
It is increasing. So whether it should increase, decrease. So all these things can be found using certain very basic formulas which you have learned in your grade 9 itself. Okay, so before I start the analysis of my projectile motion, I would like to recap certain things which you have already learned. Okay, so yes, tell me equations which we use in 1D motion. Yes, what are the equations of motion?
V is equal to u plus at.
Yes, thank you so much. Second equation?
S is equal to u
plus
half at plus half at square. Yeah, I can see a very interactive.
V square is equal to u square.
Yes, v square minus u square is 2as. Or you can write it v square as u square plus 2as as well. Very good. So if you know the equations of 1D motion, is it 1D? The motion what I am showing you, is it one dimensional?
Two-dimensional.
No, it is two-dimensional. So, you know, Galileo was the one. You know, he did certain experiment. What is special about Galileo? He was the first person to start with experimental physics. Even though those experiments were very simple, Before that, people used to go by more theory. He was the first one who proved that everything should be verified with experiments. Okay, so now, once you know these things, I'm just going to teach you a very small topic. Okay, very small information I'm giving you. I hope this you will be clear with that. Now, whenever we have something like this, it means whenever we have a vector in a given direction, it can be resolved into two parts. When I say resolved, what do I mean by that? It means these two, one and two values, when they are used together, in that case, the resultant will be the third. So how do I divide three into two? Please do not try to use the board. Thank you so much. Now, how to resolve this into two vectors? I'm going to use very basic trigonometry, and I hope you will be able to answer. Just wait, we will see whether you are able to answer or not. Now, this is base. Please do not touch the board. Thank you so much. Yes. Now, trigonometry, you use unknown divided by known. Can you just tell me in a right angle triangle, what is AX, base, hypotenuse, or perpendicular?
Base.
Base. How do you decide which side is base? The side having two angles. Even this line can be termed as base. That is very basic in trigonometry. Okay, so if this side has the second angle, then this should be treated as base. Now, what is base upon hypotenuse?
Cos theta.
Very good. So from here I can say AX is A cos theta. And similarly, I can say AY is A sin theta. So how do I remember? You can always say along the theta, the component becomes A cos theta, and away from theta, it is A sin theta. So now we are going to use what we have learned here. So can you resolve my velocity u, which is at an angle theta, into two parts? Yeah, help me please. Along the theta?
U cos theta.
And away from theta?
U sin theta.
Thank you so much. Now, we are going to use just this knowledge, horizontal motion separately and vertical motion separately, again to find the various characteristics related to projectile. As Amara said, height is changing. She said path is changing. Distance covered in horizontal direction, that was changing. So how are we going to discuss all that? Before that, I'm just going to show you something again. This is a projectile. Yes. Now, I am going to fire same projectile, but I will be showing you the velocity vectors. Yes. So, horizontal direction, there will be a vector, and in vertical direction, another vector. You need to observe carefully. I have put it in on slow mode. Okay. So, just check horizontal and the vertical component and tell me what you have learned. Any observation? If not, I'm going to pause it. Check the horizontal component and vertical component here. Check it again here.
Perpendicular to each other.
Very good. First, they are perpendicular to each other. Yes, anything else?
The horizontal maximum height parallel to the ground.
Very good. And there was someone else in between who said at maximum height?
The vertical component becomes zero.
Very good. See, whole analysis you people only have done. So I'm just helping you to find out the final expression here. So horizontal component is not changing, but vertical component is changing. First it decreased and then it increased. So I am going to treat the whole motion along the x direction as well as the y direction. I will give you how link of open board, how to use it. Plus, please don't try to use my board right now. Okay, I'm going to provide all the links, whatever you need for your later reference. Yes, thank you so much. Okay, so now when we do the analysis of projectile motion, we discuss vertical as well as horizontal motion. Yes, so now, since you have already given all the important points, we'll just jot down. In horizontal direction and then in vertical direction. Yes. What is the initial velocity? You can use this. It is?
U cos theta.
Cos theta.
Yes. And what is UY?
U sin theta.
Sin theta.
Sin theta. Now, can you just use these basic values and tell me what will be Vy? You need to use the same equation, but use the suffix x and y. What will be Vy? Uy plus?
At.
At. We are going to use Ayt. Because I said vertical direction, so you will have to use only the y component. Okay. Similarly, I'm going to use here Vx is equal to Ux plus Axt. Now, already you people have arrived at some conclusion regarding the force. Yes, again I'm saying please do not use the board. Now here, when I say vertical motion, there is a force. And what is that force? As Amara said, which was that force? Gravitational force. Very good. So what is the value of Ay?
9.8.
I am going to use right now as G. Okay, so numerical value we will put when we need basic conclusion. In the same way here, when I talk about Vx is Ux plus At, what is the value of Ax?
9.8.
Was there something along the x-axis? Did the velocity change along x-axis?
No.
So was there any force? That you people concluded in the beginning only. Yes, there is no other force. So you just have to remember. See, physics is all about that. We know everything. Just we need to know it at the right time. Okay. So Ax is zero. Ay is g. So what happens to my Vy equation now? It is u sine theta minus gt. I'm taking the direction of acceleration due to gravity towards the earth. Okay, down, so negative. What happens in Vx? I get u cos theta. Just one more equation, please help me with. I am going to use second equation of motion along x direction. So instead of s, we can write sx. Or if you want, you can just write x for ease. Yeah. What should I write? Yeah, tell me.
Uxt
1/2
half ax.
Very good. So this is what motivates a teacher. Now, what is ux here? U cos theta. What about this half axt square?
Zero.
How cos theta?
Zero. Yes. See, ax is zero, so I'm just going to leave that here itself. Yes. Now, if I use the same equation in y direction, what do I get? Y is?
2yt.
Yes.
Plus half ayt square.
Ayt square. So if I substitute the values, what do I get?
U sine theta plus yes. Half gt square. Minus half gt square.
Yes. What's your name?
Rahul.
Thank you so much, Rahul. Now, I have got the equation in x direction. I have got equation in y direction. Whatever I have highlighted or put in box, we are going to use further. Okay. So, now there are various characteristics. As I showed you, there are various characteristics. Please, I want you to erase it right now. If you have the access to the pen, you must have the access to eraser. Thank you so much. Yes, I appreciate that very much. Now you just check. For this path, time is given. Range is given. Height is given. I can just take it to any point during my path. Time is different. Range is different. Height is different. Of course, when they have developed...
Hello.
Yes? Hello. Yes, your voice is not clear. Please ask if you have any doubt. See again, all these things, when they are changing, there is a software. So it means they would have calculated it through some formulas. Okay, so those are the things which we are going to derive. Now, nobody asked me, why do we need to derive all that? Yes.
Why, ma'am?
You tell me, have you ever heard of, or have you ever seen in Olympics, discus throw, you have javelin throw, you have archery. Yes, what is the goal of disc throw or javelin throw? Yes, tell me.
What farthest are range.
Yes?
Farthest reach.
The farthest range.
Farthest reach. Why? So when I talk about farthest reach, that is also a projectile, isn't it? So when the farthest reach is possible, even when I say my initial velocity and G is constant for everybody, maximum force you can give, there is a limit. So after that, what is the technique they are practicing every time? They are practicing on changing the angle, as I'm going to show you now. Okay, so it's going to be very interesting. So first thing is, how will be the path of projectile? When I talk about path, what do you understand? Yes, in physics.
Ma'am, is it length, ma'am?
Trajectory.
Trajectory, very good. Actually, length, yes. Which trajectory when I come to, which way the particle moved? It means at any time, if I know the value of x here, I should be able to give the value of y. Have you ever learned an equation like y is equal to 2x plus 5? What do you do? Give the value of x, get the value of y, isn't it? In straight line. Yes? You have done linear equations, haven't you? Same
yes.
way. Yeah, thank you. So same way we are going to find the trajectory here. So I want a relation between x and y. What should I use? Everything is there on the board. Tell me fast, what should I use? Yes. I have x is u cos theta t. I have y as u sin theta minus half gt square.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So how do I remove t? I don't want t.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So what should I do?
Ma'am, we put all the data in the last equation. V square minus u square equal 2s.
No. What I'm going to do, I am going to find t from x equation, which is equation 1, and use it in y equation. We'll see whether we get something related to y and x. If you have pen and paper, you can do it simultaneously. So what do I get here? Half g x square by u square cos square theta. Now, what is variable and what is already given to us? What is given to us?
G, the value of g.
G is given to us, very good. What else?
X.
X, is x given?
No.
No, x you can decide, but it is an independent thing. It is your wish. Rahul says, I want this value of x. Amara says, this value of x. Similarly, we can, based on the value of x, we can find the value. So one purpose is over. I got the equation. Now, what did I say? As you are trying this, I will give you a link to try everything here. Okay, please remove these marks as soon as you're putting it. Now, y is equal to, thank you so much, Shreyas. So here, tan theta is a constant. So I am going to change this into some constant. Anyhow, it is a constant. Same way, all this underlying thing is a constant because you have given initial velocity, haven't you? Once you have projected the particle, the velocity is given by you. So I'm going to put it as some constant A and B. Now, these kind of equations, basically, just like you had y is equal to mx plus c, a straight line equation, in the same way, you are going to study actually this, that this kind of equation gives a parabolic path. So basically, you can prove here that the trajectory is parabolic. Okay, so that was the first thing. Now, as Amara said, the range, why do we need that? Okay, but then before I find the range, we need something very important to find the range, which is time of flight. Yes, what do you mean by time of flight? Hello? Physics is all about English. Yes, what is time of flight?
The time taken to reach the time taken from the starting point till the ending point.
Yes, so the, I can, very good. Who is that?
Ma'am Muskan.
Yeah, I heard that it is not Amara. Thank you, Muskan. So what is time of flight basically? It is time during the flight. Rahul, yes, move the prime pointer from here. Yes, when I say time of flight, how do I find the time of flight? Already, I think Rahul gave me the information that at maximum height, am I right, Rahul? At maximum height,
what? No, ma'am, it was someone else.
Someone else. Okay, so you tell me, Rahul, now what about the maximum height? What is so special about that? What was the velocity at maximum height?
Vertical velocity zero.
Vertical velocity zero. Very good. The person who answered, you were very, very clear in answering. Never say velocity is zero. It is velocity in y direction is zero. So if velocity in y direction is zero, I already have an equation. So can I use this equation and get some time? What is the value of time? Can you tell me? Because this is a simple equation you can solve. I got u sine theta by g. Is it time of flight?
It's time of ascent.
No. Time of ascent. It's the time to go up. Very good. So it is time to just go up to reach the maximum height. But since I'm saying air resistance is not there, so it means time of ascent should be equal to time of descent in this particular case. Yes. So what will be my total time? That will be 2u sine theta by g. Now this is the result which I will be using in one more case. Now I'm coming to third, and right now the last characteristic, other characteristic you try driving yourself, okay? So I am coming to the next characteristic, which is the range of the projectile. Range means how far. This was our doubt, isn't it? How to throw my disc at maximum distance. So if I need to discuss range, I need to take horizontal motion into consideration or vertical?
Horizontal.
Horizontal. Horizontal.
Very good. Very good. So you already know the formula for velocity is distance by time. So how do I find horizontal distance? Using horizontal velocity into time. So from here, once I substitute the value, I get u cos theta, and total time here is 2u sine theta. Okay, so can I just write it as u square into 2 sine theta cos theta? Yes, what should I write it as?
U square sine 2 theta by g.
Sine 2 theta by g. So this is the expression for the range. Now, when my range is going to be maximum? When sine to theta is?
Theta is 45.
Theta is 45. Very good. So when it is 1, it means sine 90. And I can say from here 2 theta is 90 and theta is 45. Thank you so much, Rahul. Now, we are just going to solve a small problem based on the same. Okay. And at the end of the class, I'm just going to post a form here wherein you can try the question and whatever knowledge you have learned or you had already known, you can just check it. Okay, self-assessment. Now I'll just take 2 minutes of your time. Yes. We are going to do the second question. The first question, again, I can give it as a sway link to you. You can try it out yourself. Here, a ball rolls off the top of the staircase with a horizontal velocity. So I'm just going to show what is the velocity. U, since it is horizontal, no cos theta, sine theta. Yes. Now, if the steps are h meter in height, can you tell me what will be the vertical height if there are n stairs? One step has height h. So what will be total height?
NH.
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 Same way, if one step has the width W, what will be the total width?
NW.
Yes. And what just now we have learned, that range is given as horizontal velocity into time. Can you say what is the range right now from the figure?
N omega.
N omega. So from here I can get the value of T. That's the first thing which I learned from my given figure.
What is omega?
W.
Angular velocity.
No, here I'm using it as W. Okay, no angular velocity. The next is, in the y direction, you have already found NH. So what is y direction equation? Ut plus half AYT square. And you already know the value of Y. What is UY? Only horizontal velocity. Yes. So what is UY? Zero. So from here, I get half n square omega square by u square. Can you just solve this equation? N gets cancelled. From here, what do you get the value of n? 2 u square h divided by g omega square. See, I just redistributed the term. So was this the same? Yes. So my projectile will hit the edge only when the number of stairs is equal to this. So in the similar way, you can solve the other problems as well. And I'll be sending you the link of forms as well. Okay, so I hope you had an interesting session.